Grazie.
Thank you.
Cinco de Mayo. We are very glad to see everyone here. I'd like to thank you on behalf of all the Red Regiment band members and directors for coming to attend our concert tonight. We'd like to remind you that we are live streaming, and so if you please have a cell phone, if you please turn it off or turn the ringer down, that would be very helpful. We are going to delay just for about 5 minutes because we have a tuba player. He's a very important tuba player, and he's running a little behind, so we're going to delay about 5 minutes, but we were hoping that you guys would take that time to read your program notes, and if you didn't get program notes, that QR code will get you there. Okay, because it kind of, it will help you understand all the music you're going to hear tonight. But I know you're going to enjoy it. And once again, thank you for coming. We've always known that the support that we get from the community and from school is the best there is. We appreciate it. Okay, so we'll be back with you in about 5 minutes.
Thank you.
selection is called Imaginarium, and it will be conducted by Mr. Neil Grace.
Thank you.
Our next selection is the English Folk Song Suite, composed by Ralph Vaughan Williams. And this work is in three movements. And so it's not really customary to clap between each movement. You can wait till the very end. And you'll know because I'll turn around and that's it. So here we go, English Folk Song Suite.
Thank you.
Thank you. I had to understand because that is one major work. That was a low claim they just did. You guys may see it. And I will recognize the soloist on that. Oh, and I hope I don't miss anybody. Ashley Lindsay had some really nice planet work. Ashley Lindsay. Marcella Vargas on the oboe. Beautiful oboe parts. Three of our trumpets got into the action. Camila Vargas, Travis Emery, and Dylan Strange. I don't know that it was Mark Solo, but Darcy Woody sure had a lot of people going on in that. But I do want to commend everyone for doing such a great job. This is a hard work, like I said in the pro notes. I played it in college at UT, so it's a hard work, like I said in the pro notes. I played it in college at UT, so it's major. But anyway, we're going to take a minute and recognize the seniors, and that will let these guys rest a bit before the second half of the concert. So, that's on the paper. We have an outstanding class of seniors this year. 17 of them, I've counted correctly. And the first couple here have not been a band this spring, so they're not on stage. But if they're here in the audience, I would love if they'd stand up and I'll say a few kind words about them. I'm mostly focusing on what they've done during their band career and give them a little recognition about what they've done and what's to come. So the first one is Lily Asbury. So Lily was in 4 years of marching band, 3 years of concert band. She was in our woodwind quintet, participated in solo and ensemble, was a field show soloist, our resident artist, because she's wonderful at art. And she will be attending Deep Springs College in Deep Springs, California next fall to study art. So if you know Lily, then she's a great person. Thank you so much. Next we have Steve Blanchett. He was 4 years of marching band, 3 years of concert band, but is not here this evening because he was not in the spring semester. He was a percussionist. Another percussionist, Jamie Crabtree, was in 4 years of marching and 3 years of concert band. She got something kind of special this fall called the Ian Willis Perseverance Award, and that was presented at Music in the Castle. So that was really special for Jamie. And she's planning to major in music education, but we don't know exactly which college yet. I'm not sure she's decided. Jonathan Norman, I see here tonight. So Jonathan is one of our major Color Guard members, one of our seniors. I'm pretty sure he was in all 4 years of Color Guard and Winter Guard. He was soloist in Guard. And he is planning to attend Maryville College this fall to major in vocal music education. So now, leave the rest of them are here on stage. Travis Henry, will you please stand up? So Travis is a 4-year marching band, 4-year concert band member. He participates in solo and ensemble every year at the TSSBDA Senior Clinic. And I'll mention that a lot. So what that stands for is Tennessee Secondary School Band Directors Association. So TSSBDA is just an easier way to say it. He also was a 2022 Bravo Award finalist. That's a Rose Center program that's really special. And he will be attending Mars Hill University this fall to study political science. Travis Emery. Victoria King. Victoria has been in 4 years of marching band, 4 years of concert band, also has participated in solo and ensemble in the TWSBDA Senior Clinic, and as a matter of fact, this year, Victoria won the TWSBDA College Scholarship through auditions and, an interview and application, and she is attending Morris Hill University, along with Travis, this fall, to study music education. Katie Martin, or Mary Catherine Martin, shall we call you? we know her as Katie. Katie has been 4 years in marching band, 4 years in concert band, and also has participated in solo ensemble for many, many years, and has done both TWSBDA junior and senior clinic. So she's done TWSBDA a lot. So Katie's not quite sure of her future plans, but she's working on it. And we know Katie's going to be successful in whatever she chooses to do. Katie Martin. Layla Matela. Wait a minute, Layla. Layla is in the percussion section. She has been in 4 years of marching band, 4 years of concert band. And Layla didn't really have any plans yet, but just like Katie, we know she'll be successful. I think everybody that's gone through the band program has a little leg up to success in life. So Layla and Taylor. DJ Owens. Yes, so glad DJ made it. DJ has been 4 years in marching band, 4 years in concert band. He was a field show soloist actually as a younger fellow when he played in the quintet on the side of the field. He was a sophomore then? Huh? You're a sophomore, junior? No, I mean when he played. Sophomore, so he was, because I mean, it was mostly older people. It was like, you know, it's DJ and Noah Moody and, you know, some of the older crew. So DJ kind of got an early leg up on that because he's a really fine tuba player. That's why we kind of had to wait on him. DJ has also participated in solo and ensemble and Tita West VDA Senior Clinic. And DJ was unplanned yet for the future, but once again, I know he'll be successful. DJ Owens. Harrison Sampson. So Harrison has been, get this, 5 years of marching band, because he started as an eighth grader, 4 years of concert band, jazz band here at T.L. Smith, here at CCHS, I'm getting my names messed up. He was our drum major this past year. He's always participated in solo and ensemble, TWSBDA Junior and Senior Clinic, ETSBOA Junior and Senior Clinic, and ETSBOA is East Tennessee School Band and Orchestra Association. So that's just another one. It's a little more prestigious, a little harder to make those clinics. That's why we have fewer people that can do that. He also went to the pinnacle of clinics and made All-State this year. And he's been a member of our Woodwind Quintet, our saxophone quartet here at CCHS. He made the All-East Tennessee Jazz Band. He's played with the Walter State Jazz Band. He attended Tennessee Governor's School for the Arts on his bassoon. He was a member this year of the Knoxville Youth Symphony Orchestra. He was the 2022 first place Bravo Award winner. And he is planning to attend Belmont University this fall as a music major with a chemistry minor. Harrison Sampson. Dylan Strange. Also was a field show soloist, as y'all probably remember this year. He has always done solo and ensemble, TWSBDA and ETSBOA Senior Clinic. He was a 2022 Bravo Award finalist, playing the Humble Trumpet Concerto, I might add. That's another real big piece of literature. And he is planning to attend the University of Tennessee at Martin to major in biology. Dylan Strange. Sergio Trevino, and Sergio was here and he had to leave, but I'll go ahead and recognize him. He's 4 years of marching band, 4 years of concert band, TWSBDA Junior Clinic, and he applied to go, or is applying, for the School of Art Institute of Chicago, which when he told me, I thought that was a weird name, but I looked it up and that's true. School of the Art Institute of Chicago, I don't know, but it's a really prestigious art school, because Sergio was really into art also. So that was Sergio Trevino, and now we'll go on to Camila Vargas. Camila, 4 years of marching band, 4 years of concert band, CCHS jazz band, always went to solo ensemble, TWSBDA Senior Clinic, and she was the 2022 third place Bravo Award winner. And she is planning to attend University of Tennessee at Chattanooga to study to become a midwife. Aiden Williamson. Yeah. I feel like this. Aiden was in marching band for 6 years. I think that's a record. Because he started as a seventh grader. He's been 4 years of concert band, which that's kind of standard because really you can't get the kids out of class to come over to concert band from middle school. So that's kind of normal. He's always been a member of the CCHS Jazz Band, the Saxophone Quartet. He was selected for the HSBOA Jazz Clinic this year. He's always attended Solo Ensemble and Tina West BDA Senior Clinic. And he was the 2022 second place Bravo Award winner. So you see the pattern here? We had first, second, and third place, and two other finalists for the Bravo Award. So I think we kind of swept up on that one. But we're proud of him for that. And Aiden is planning to attend MTSU to major in audio engineering. Aiden Lindsay. Ashton Whitney. Marching band. He's been in marching band for 5 years, concert band for 4 years. He's in the CCHS Jazz Band, and he's been in the Woodwind Quintet, always attended Solo Ensemble, and DWSBDA, and ETSBOA Senior Clinic. And he is planning next fall, to attend Neumont College of Computer Science in Salt Lake City, Utah. Pretty exciting. Ashton Whitney. Danielle Roberts-Wolfer. I saw her there. Stand up, Danielle. So Danielle is in 4 years of... Okay, young man. She's in 4 years of marching band, 3 years of concert band. Just couldn't do it this semester. She was our band captain, and she is planning to attend UT Knoxville to major in theater. Danielle Roberts-Wolfer. And Darcy Woody. Darcy has been 4 years in marching band, 4 years in concert band in our Woodwind Quintet. Has always attended Solo and Ensemble, and she's done the Tina West BDA Senior Clinic. And she is planning to attend Walter State to major in early childhood education. Darcy Woody. So there is our fine class of Red Regiment seniors. We love them all. We're going to miss them, but we know they're going to do great things. Now, Mr. Hicks. I don't know if he wants to take a little break or if he's ready for his piece. Or maybe a little more than that. Yeah. He wants us to take about a 2 minute break, but if you guys need to go to the restroom, that'll be fine. Just be sure to come back, because there's more good stuff to come. Okay, so let's say a 5 minute break. Just give you a little time to use the restroom. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
open up for the sort of the second half of the concert. It's called Deer Path Dances by David Holsinger. It'll be conducted by Mr. Travis Hicks.
Thank you. for this last piece, we had the wonderful opportunity to be part of a commissioning consortium. Basically, what that means is that a bunch of schools, organizations, people, it can be various things, get together and put in money to pay a composer to write a piece, usually either designed by, given by things that the consortium says that they want out of peace, or around an idea or a theme. And this one is around mental health. And there's much more about it in the program notes. But I actually got a video from the composer of a short little introduction to the piece, so we're gonna play that now for you, and then we'll play a piece.
Hello, my name is Randall Standridge, and I'm the composer of the work you are about to hear, Not Alone. Not Alone was created through a consortium of over 300 schools and organizations who came together to support the creation of a piece of art that would further and represent discussions about mental health conditions. In this work, you will hear some dark moments at the beginning, starting with a solo voice with a bittersweet melody, representing an individual living with such conditions. The piece devolves into a moment of profound despair, anger, and fear as the individual reaches their lowest point. However, at the ending, the original melody returns as the individual has received the help they needed and truly realized that they are not alone. We hope this work will provoke discussions about mental health conditions and also perhaps encourage those of you that might be secretly suffering with such conditions to seek the help you need. Please know that you are not alone and that happiness and help is possible. I want to thank all of the organizations who have come together to support this work. And speaking as a person who lives with depression and anxiety myself, I hope that we can tear down the taboos and make discussing mental health normal. Thank you for your time. I hope you enjoy the piece. And as always, peace, love, and music.
Thank you so much for coming out to our concert tonight. I hope it was enjoyable to listen to. It was quite a selection of different types of pieces. And we're very happy to be able to be a little part of the premiering of that last piece. I need to thank a couple of people. I also need to thank our admin. I saw Ms. Burgeon here, Ms. Brawley's here. They're always super, super supportive of everything that we do. That's fantastic. I tell my friends constantly that we have the best admin, and they're very jealous. I need to thank our boosters who give us money to do things, which is great. In fact, I called Holly the day I found out about this commissioning thing and said, we need to jump on this now. She's like, yeah, sure, I guess. So we were able to jump in on it right immediately off the bat. And speaking of boosters, I need to do my normal booster plug. They have meetings on the first Monday of every month. So the next one is June 2nd, 6th. Sorry, I just know it's the very first Monday of June. And that's at 6 in the band room. So please come and find out what is going on and how you can help us out, because we need lots and lots of support, not just financially, but also just people around to help us out, especially as we approach the fall season. Let me just go through a couple events that are important over the next couple weeks. Monday night, we have our banquet, so if you have not RSVP, you need to do that so we can figure out how much food to get. That was on the remind link I sent out. Tuesday night, we are having an informational meeting in the band room for Marching Band. That is for parents and students. We will announce the show theme, we will announce section leaders, we will announce drum major, and we'll go through the handbook as well. So make sure you come out for that. And then the following week, on Tuesday, we will have our small ensemble concert, also as chamber music, which will do jazz band, and we'll feature a whole bunch of these kiddos in a smaller setting. It's a great way for them to express their musicianship and show off the talent in a little bit more personal way. And then we have a couple things throughout the summer as far as for getting us ready towards the fall. That will be up on our website soon. Our website is bit.ly/CC band. B is capitalized as well. Okay. CCRR, all caps, band. Also, if you scan the QR code, that took you to our website as well, so you can navigate around from there. Is that all?
Ten of these five students are going to perform on May 15th at the Lutheran Church of Morristown. They got invited to be part of their Young Artist Series there. It's actually a paying gig. They're getting $50 a piece. So music does pay off when you get good. So we had 10 students that had a lot of things prepared. As you can tell, they've done everything this spring. So they're going to get to play that afternoon at 3 o'clock, and it's free to the public. So if you guys would like to come and support them, that would be wonderful. And that will be live stream too, actually.
That's all I got to think. So thank you again so much for coming. And try to come out and see us not next week, the following week for our small ensemble concert. Thanks.
Sound effect, so it's not right on. Get her attention.